The sign reads, wanted, gay men with a gay brother. It's not a personal ad for someone looking for a gay partner. Instead, it's from a man on a quest to find answers about the origins of homosexuality. That man is a researcher from the Evanston Northwestern Healthcare Research Institute who is conducting the largest study to date to see if genetics play a role in homosexuality.
I don't expect them to find, you know, a gay gene.
But Chad Zawitz does suspect genes are somehow involved. He knows from the time he was a teenager, he didn't feel comfortable dating girls.
I was pretty much in question or in doubt for, you know, all through high school and most of college.
By age 23, he knew he was gay. His little brother Scott came to terms with his own sexuality a short time later.
I don't think about it. I don't worry about it. It's like one teeny tiny small portion of like who I am.
The brothers say they always knew there was a reason. Chad, the doctor, naturally turned to science.
I've always sort of had this feeling there was likely to be at least a partial genetic component to homosexuality.
So when he saw this flyer looking for gay brothers to join a study exploring genetic causes for homosexuality, he quickly signed up. Dr. Alan Sanders is conducting the study. He is not gay. The Evanston Northwestern researcher is interested in the genetic influence for homosexuality. He's enlisted 700 pairs of gay brothers. They fill out a questionnaire, then submit a DNA sample in the form of blood or saliva. It's all analyzed in this lab, where Dr. Sanders and his team will sift through the information, looking for the specific gene or genes involved.
The most positive thing would be to better understand the development of sexual orientation.
But the results won't just provide information. They could alter attitudes.
The more someone believes that there's somewhat of a biological explanation, which certainly would include genetics, but it could include other things, the more accepting or tolerant their attitudes might be about the trait in general.
There are huge, I guess, socio-political implications of figuring out if there's a genetic or a sort of it's not your fault or you didn't choose to be this way.
But the conservative Americans for Truth says you can choose not to act on homosexuality.
Regardless of what the study finds, our moral view of homosexuality remains the same. We believe that homosexuality is about behavior that's changeable, that is wrong, and that in many instances is destructive.
If we're all created by a God, then God had to have created the gene that made me gay.
Still, having the science to back up a religious argument doesn't take away the potential for other prejudice.
Some people have asked me about the study and they said, well, you know, if they find a gene, then, you know, then it can be treated or cured as if it were a disease.
Right.
And, you know, that does bring up sort of scary sort of Holocaust ideas.
One fear, screening an embryo for so-called gay genes and choosing not to have a gay child. Dr. Possibly Sanders says that's not likely since he doesn't believe there's only one gene involved. In the nature versus nurture argument, he says there's no clear winner. It's a combination.
So we're talking about complex genetic scenarios, multiple genes involved, environment very important.
We know in our hearts and our minds and our beings that we didn't choose to be gay. I am 100% positive it's a genetic thing.
Dr. Sanders is looking to study 1,000 pairs of gay brothers total. Smaller studies have already found sexual orientation tends to cluster in families and can be inherited. Dr. Sanders says he didn't include lesbians because he's building on past research in men. And if you would like more information about the study, you can log on to our website and we will have some links on there. The doctor says he expects to have the first results of this later this year.
It's very important.
Mm-hmm. It'll be very interesting to see how things flesh out.
They feel it could change perceptions of
absolutely, and that would be something very important, I think.
Absolutely.
It's a huge debate. Thank you.